I think by the time we got into original soundtrack, we'd shown that our way of doing things could be successful. So we were left alone to crack on with things. And we were trying a bit harder to push our boundaries in different ways.
There was always still this desire to go one better with a song and do something different with it. Hence, I'm Not In Love. The way that song developed, which, looking back on it, it was astounding. We ever released it, we ever got it out, we ever got it finished.
The title was Eric's. We'd been discussing writing a love song, but I don't think we wanted to write a cliche. And I'm Not In Love was the perfect title.
I wrote all the words, completely. And I took it into the studio, and Graham Gilman said, I'll finish it with you. I think there's a great idea there. So we sat down, we completed it. Graham put some lovely chords into it. And we went in the studio to record it as a bossa nova. Congos and things, and bongos.
I'm not in love, so don't forget it. It's just a silly phase I'm going through.
When we heard it back, everyone was underwhelmed, I think is the best word. And it was, nobody had the real enthusiasm to carry on with it. It sounded so underwhelming.
Yeah, I hated it. Oh, sure, I'll say I didn't like it particularly. I didn't get it particularly. There was something in there. And we all recognised that there was something in there, but that treatment didn't really bring it to life. We weren't really sure what we could do with it. I think I said at the time, well, why don't we do it with voices, no instruments, just all a tsunami of voices, wash of voices. Probably out of desperation, really, trying to come up with something to make this thing come to life.
I said, what do you mean, a cappella? You know, we all sing without a backing. He said, no, the backing track. Let's do the whole backing track with voices, like a massive choir, the biggest choir you can imagine. I said, great, how do we do it? How do we do that? There's only four of us. And Lol said, tape loops. I said, great, all right, let's do it. And we spent 3 weeks recording three of them in the studio, Kevin, Lol and Graham, singing, ah, as long as they could hold their breath. Then they did that 16 times on the 16-track machine, copied all that across to a stereo machine, and we had 13 notes to choose from, a chromatic scale with a top C and a bottom C. And 624 voices were there at our disposal. I then played them back through the 16-track machine, through the control desk, and I gave each of us a set of three faders to go up and down when the chords were changing for I'm Not In Love, and the little
All of us worked the desk and played it like a keyboard. And when we had all the notes playing together, you got that lovely abstract, because it's a mass of harmonics all bleeding together. So we kept them, all of the notes, in to a certain degree with a piece of masking tape so that the faders were all at a certain level. And that's what made that in-tune harmonic sound, but with an extra something. And it made something really special.
Originally, I think we were going to do it with just voices, nothing else. So we recorded a rhythm track, which we thought was going to be a temporary. And I think the idea was that we'd sing to that and do all the vocals, then we'd take that off and we'd be left with this song recorded with just the choir and the vocals. But there was something about it, there was magic about it. And of course, once we put the other voices on, we didn't want to touch anything, we didn't want to take it out.
So don't forget it. It's just a silly phase I'm going through.
I did the lead vocal again, but the guy vocal I'd done was so good, we kept it. So it was basically finished. And then you come to the Godly and Cream moment again. What should we do next? Just as we said that, the secretary at the studio, Kathy Redfern, popped her head round the door. She said, Eric, there's a phone call for you.
And then they said, that's it. So I immediately turned round and ran back to the reception area. I thought, no way. And Lowell came after me, actually, and took me in and said, we want you to do something for us. All the time I'm thinking, no, I can't sing, I can't do this. And I remember Kev came in with me into the studio and they said, you've just got to whisper. Be quiet. Big boys don't cry. Big boys don't cry. Big boys don't cry.
In those days, we tried everything. If someone had an idea, it got tried. It didn't always work, but I think it was just one of those sessions where whatever you added to it after a certain point, it just kept on getting better. You know, astonishing.
The thing was, when we'd recorded it, we used to turn the lights off in the control room and just lie down on the floor and play it to ourselves. But not one of us said, oh, this could be a hit. It was only when we took it out for the studio, I played it to our friends and family and the record company there. Everyone said, this could be a single, it'd be a big hit.
It was just so wonderful to be involved with that track, and it's been the best track that I have ever had the pleasure of being involved with, really. It was just, you know, it was just something, you know, you look up to the gods and say thank you when something like that comes in front of the speakers.
Fabulous song. I still love hearing it now. I don't think you ever get fed up with it, actually. It just stops you on your tracks, really. And no one would think that you'd still be hearing it all those years later. I'm not
alone. First time I ever heard I'm Not In Love, I thought it was absolutely brilliant. I thought I'd never heard anything like that before. And when I really started producing records in 1975, but it took me till late 1979 to have a hit. And through those years, whenever we got really excited about something that we'd done, I always used to say, come on, we've got to put on I'm Not In Love and just remind ourselves, you know, cure our studio fever, because it was such a great sounding record. So if I call you, you'll make a fuss.
Don't tell your friends about the two of us. I remember when I'm Not In Love came out, and everyone was just in awe, because A, it was a great song, had a great melody, but the idea of the lyric was fabulous. This, he complains too much aspect of it. And then the sound, the multi-layered vocals were a real treat to the ear. It's quite ironic that it comes out close in time to Bohemian Rhapsody, because those two are really the great multi-track hits of, dare I say, all time.
Love, no, no. boys don't cry. Big boys don't cry. Big boys don't cry. Big boys don't cry. Big boys don't cry.
Stain, there's love.